the quality of engineers that we are getting from the academia into the industry, it took us a lot of while to extract a dollar value from them. It took about 18 months for us to basically take what you have given us and make meaningful use for us. And this was a big, it almost, and the quality of engineers was one thing, the quantity was one thing, there was no kind of, you know, a set parameter that we think that the input to this industry is, it's not an IT industry, it's an industry where people need to be having a creative bent of mind, so we are into design and everything. So it almost was an existential issue for us, that we really need to do something different. Then we thought, what about if the last 6 months or the last 1 year of students' life in the campuses, can we take the industry to the campus? Because we realize that there is two aspects to the problem. One is obviously the infrastructure. Right now, academia is here, industry is here in terms of infrastructure. When I say infrastructure, there are many facets to it. It is basically not only computers, it is not only machines and high. There is a lot of things in terms of physical infrastructure, in terms of hardware, software, the models. So there is one part is infrastructure. But even if we install the best machines in VIT or MIT or anywhere in the world, right, the content is still you won't get. The content is the live projects that are happening in the market today. If you see what is happening in the transport industry, in 2030 India is talking about not having petrol or diesel cars on the road. They want to go EV. China EV is growing at double digit growth. So the entire mobility segment is transforming. So basically, even if we give you the infrastructure, you're not going to have the content for the students to play with, to understand that content, to bring real life projects to the campus. So the second problem was content. The third problem is, if we give you the infrastructure, we give you the content, who's going to teach it, right? You guys are basically into your regular syllabus teaching. So who's going to teach it? And we need to put up some structure around this content so the students can basically absorb the content in the fashion that they absorb in the current academic content. So we said, let's invest our time into building this content, taking this real life content to some of these institutes. And this is, again, I've said, we're doing this for ourselves in terms of getting the right kind of value from day one for the students. So we really invested a complete team. Pushkara Skaurdu, who is the head of the education, a team was formed under him. He basically packaged all the content. He basically understood what are the six or seven things that the industry, the academy is lacking. There are six labs that we came up with. Those labs ke saath, what we can teach, what is needed in terms of the infrastructure, and he developed a complete package for education. And that's where the starting point was, that content competency curriculum has to be integrated. Because otherwise it just becomes, You are not the first one to do collaborations. You had Bosch and everybody started. Where it failed is everybody came, installed a machine and walked out. And there was no skin in the game, as we say, right? And that's where we said, if we just install the machine and say, good luck, see you in the next one, it won't happen. So we really invested our time and effort to make this, as you said, right, you care and have a responsibility to the students. We care for our employees as well. And if we get employees who are going to take 18 months to derive a value out of them, it is a disservice that we are doing to our company. So this was the entire thought process to get association like brand like VIT, where we can invest and you guys can equally come up and rise to the occasion and say this is what. Now what this means to the students is a lot of things, right? A, they get to work in this campus, the cutting edge technology and the cutting edge, the same machine that is today used by Tata Technologies to deliver the best EV that we are doing in China. The same machine here is the machine that we are doing a Discovery Land Rover for Jaguar in our campus. The same machine that we are putting a PLM software for Boeing and Airbus inside our campus. So it's a replica that we intend to do at some of these relationships that we have. And that was very exciting for everybody. It was exciting for the students, it was exciting for the college, and it was exciting for us, because once these students come into our campus as our employees, I can put them and make them, in our commercial terms, billable on day one. So the value in we say we monetize the investments very quickly. We basically say this is what I get, a ready engineer versus a somewhat half student who's got some experience with it.